Travel and the administration for all their support of our athletics. We would not have the program that we have here without all their support. So we really appreciate it. Thank you so much. I didn't know what I was how I was going to start this tonight and everything else, and then something came across that, and my son is a coach, so I thought, wow, I'm going to send this to some of his players. And it was
the high school level.
Minor paychecks don't warrant the time to spend. More and more coaches are getting burned out by overzealous parents. Be an agent of change. Thank your coach. Tell them that you appreciate what they do for you. It will mean more to them than you'll ever know. So if you get a chance tonight, thank these wonderful men and ladies that, believe me, they do not get paid very much for what they do. They do it for the love of the game and also the love of our girls here. So please take some time to do that. Appreciate it. Thank your parents, you know, for all the late dinners and all the, you know, the crying and the yelling and the, we would never do that, but just thank them for all the rides and all the time and everything else and all their love and support. Again, that really will mean a lot. So without further ado, you don't need to hear from me, you always hear from me on Mondays, so we're going to start in alphabetical order. We're going to start with Coach Greg Sweet with our cross-country team.
Surprise, and this year is no different. And the surprise is always that my team impresses me more off the field than they do on the field, which is a hard thing to do. This year, we came out, did really well at Bullis, did really well at Covenant Life, winning that tournament. We showed up at Landon, the defending champions, right? And I told you guys that. We're the defending champions. We have this. All you have to do is produce. And you guys let St. John's and Ironton off the hook that day. And I was really disappointed. And I can tell you that. I was disappointed. And it's hard to be disappointed at 9 o'clock on a Saturday morning. And you could have gone back to the tent and stuffed your face and laid on the tent and waited for the JV to finish and we all go home. And it was homecoming that night, I think. But you went out. And you cheered the JV team on from the amphitheater and from the scoreboard, and you stopped at the finish line and cheered them on at the finish line. And what I missed as a coach, and sometimes it's hard being a coach because you miss all these little things while you're trying to do what you do, was what you did at the finish line. And I didn't find that out until the end of the meet when we have the coaches meeting and we're breaking down everything, and the Landon AD comes running up to me. And his assistant, which was our own. You're the coach of that purple team. And I was amazed that they didn't know it was Holy Cross. But I said, all right, I'll take it. I said, yes, I'm the coach of the purple team. Holy Cross, thank you. AHC, nobody knows what AHC is. And she said, oh my goodness, your girls were standing at the finish line cheering on your runners. They were cheering on the St. John's runners, the Ironton runners, when they were close races down at the end of the line. They were jumping up and down. They were handing everybody glasses of water, bottles of water. She goes, your team is amazing. They're outstanding. They're welcome back at Landon anytime. Anytime we have an event, your girls are welcome back here. And I went in 1 minute from being like, we're going to be running hills on Monday, kind of being disgusted. I was getting choked up the way she was talking. And she said it in front of the St. John's coach, and the Holton coach, and the Stone Ridge coach, and the Ironton coach, and the Mercersburg coach. And they all heard it. That was the best thing you guys did all year. Nothing you did. It says Holy Cross on it. There's no walking after this point. Okay, it says Holy Cross. What people think of this institution here is based on what they see on those 4 or 5 hours on a Saturday morning. Some people see us once on a Saturday. Your whole impression is based upon what you do. And that day wasn't the out of bounds. That's what you guys do every Saturday. So thank you very much. My Saturday went from being kind of upset with you at 9:30 to at 9:32. I was floating on cloud nine the rest of Saturday. It was a great Saturday for me. Just don't let St. John's in the door again, okay? The first award tonight, most improved. The history of this in Holy Cross Cross Country is whoever wins the most improved, usually within the next 1 or 2 years, is the MVP. Okay, and that isn't going to happen tonight. If for no other reason than our most improved runner happens to be a senior, and this was her only year at cross country. She came out the very first week of practice when it's 90 degrees and 80% humidity, and she said, "Coach, I'm here to run cross country, but I can't run cross country." I was like, "Okay, great, what's up?" She goes, "I have an oblique strain." And I said, "Okay, so what were you doing, playing softball during the summer?" She goes, "No." And I was like, "How do you strain your oblique if you're not swinging a baseball bat?" We never got to the bottom of it. But for the next 3 weeks, she showed up at practice every day. She held a clipboard. She held a stopwatch. If I said, "Walk over here and watch the girls and tell me what time they come by," she did that. She did everything she needed to do while she was, you know, incapacitated, injured, couldn't run. Very first week of the season, I made my first big mistake. I said, "You know what? You haven't been training. You haven't been running. I'll put you on JV. Okay? I know you're good enough to run varsity, but let's put you on JV. Let's get you used to all the activity, all the excitement." And in Covenant Life, she won the JV race by a minute, which is a mile in cross country. The coaches came up to me and said, "Coach, what are you doing? You're running a senior in JV." I go, "She hasn't run in 3 weeks." They went, "All right." So that was my first mistake. I should have put you right up to varsity. There should have been no reason for you to run JV. It was an outstanding year for you. You never ran JV the rest of the year. So our most improved runner for 2016 was Teresa Rogers. Sent her on her way, and I told her everything to do except relax. And as she went running up that hill, passing runners, I was trying to run after her and tell her, "No, stop. Don't do it." And I couldn't catch her because it was up a hill, obviously. So I thought to myself, "Well, I'll just cut through the course. I'll meet her at 1 foot and tell her, slow down, slow down, slow down." And I got to that point, and I'm waiting, and I'm waiting, and I'm waiting, and she's not there. And I'm thinking, "Oh, she died. She's on her knees somewhere back in the woods." So I go running backwards. I can't find her anywhere. And I'm thinking, "Oh, what did I do?" So I run around, look, look, look. I get down to the finish line, and there she is. She's got her medal around her neck, and she's waiting for me. And from that point on, I knew that's it. She's a varsity runner. The very next week, we had a six-inch rope lift tournament. "How long can you keep your heels off the ground, 6 inches off the ground?" I had to stop her at the 4 minute mark just because I said, "All right, look, we got to have practice. You could probably lay here all day. You know what? We got to do practice." She finished first for us in all of our varsity meets this year. And I was so happy to help her out do a physical fitness performance for the United States Coast Guard Academy. And she continues on the line of MVPs. She was last year's most improved runner. So this year's MVP goes to Grace Tarver.
Rose, Isabel Fontana, and Kylie Braddock. center midfield, we found out, well, she's really indispensable at that position. Ended up keeping her in pretty much all the games the whole time through. So, toward the end of the season, we ended up moving her off to varsity, and she ended up starting for varsity. And, you know, you really knew how much we missed her when I had other girls coming up to me on the sideline in our last, like, two or three games saying, we really need to get Katie back on JV. You need to go talk to the varsity coach. Like, that's not how it works, guys. But our partner award is Isabella Fontana. Isabella played offense, and we had eight offenders rotating between three positions. So it's hard to get everybody playing time. Isabella got a lot of playing time because she really hustled. I mean, I would see her just take off, like, really very aggressive position and just go at the ball, whatever. The thing that made her stand out as far as the Tartan Award is concerned, though, is she really had fortitude and just initiative. I'm going to tell a story, and she's probably not going to like recalling the story, but the best incident of the entire season, game of Bishop Ireton, we had a stroke called in our favor. Strokes in field hockey are like penalty kicks in soccer. You have just one player against the goalie and a hit. That's all you get. So high pressure, very difficult situation. I'm on the sideline looking around who can take it. I'm looking at all my players. Everyone's like, don't pick me. Without even asking for it, Isabel stepped up and took the shot. Didn't score, but in all seriousness, I couldn't have been more proud of her. I mean, at the end of the game, I saw her. She didn't feel so good, but I was really, really impressed to see her step up. All right.
I'd like to begin by thanking all the people that made this field hockey season so memorable for me. Everyone in the administration, starting with Mrs. Preble, and everyone on the athletic staff, Lisa, Dina, and Deirdre, who were great. And to all the supportive parents, though I couldn't begin to name all the people, and players, particularly the captains, Sydney, Maddie, Sophie, and Lynn. I especially appreciated my right-hand woman and help, Cindy Benedetti, who has always been there to give me advice and guidance. And my daughter, Coach Swift, who coached until the beginning of October until she had to go to Spain to teach, and Coach Conti. I must say this is really great to be back. I coached field hockey here from 2005 to 2009, and we won the WCAC three of those years. After coaching over 30 years in the public school system, I retired from MCPS, and I thought this past summer that I would be finished with my coaching. Little did I know, 2 weeks before the season started, I received a call from Ms. Schrader and Cindy Benedetti asking if I would be interested in the varsity job. I thought about it, and I didn't know what to expect, but I knew this, that the Holy Cross girls were always polite, they were always enthusiastic, and they were very athletic. So I thought, why not give it a try? And I have to say, the girls didn't disappoint me. And what you said, Ms. Schrader, earlier about thank your coach, that's one big difference I see with this school and the public school system. Almost every day practice, even when we had a Saturday practice at 8:00 in the morning, they always ended the day by thank you, coach, thank you, coach, thank you, coach, whether we won or lost. And it really made the coach and the other coach feel very good. So I just want to say thank you for saying thank you. Even though we didn't have a winning record this year, we were 5-10, We were 5-4 in the WCAC. We had some very incredible games, beginning with our double overtime opener against Wooten to our 2-1 win in the quarterfinals against St. Mary's Riken. After our last game, which was a 5-0 defeat to Good Counsel, the team probably felt like the cross-country coach felt at 9:30 in the morning, a little bit deflated, a little bit defeated. But I have to say, thinking about it that afternoon, the next day, I really wasn't discouraged, and that's for two reasons. One, I know that this group and the group that's coming back is a very resilient one. And number two, I look at what's coming ahead. With a season of 8-2-3, the JV was really phenomenal. So I know next year is going to be a great year. We're going to bounce back and bring back this trophy. We had some very outstanding players who received some awards this season. I just want to mention briefly. Anna King and Sydney Bruno were selected to the WCAC first team. Emily Koch was selected to the second team. And Maddie Danino, Eileen Din, and Bryn Estrella were selected to the honorable mention WCAC team. Bryn is also currently playing tonight in an all-senior game at Archbishop Spalding. He couldn't be here tonight. Now for special awards for the MVP. This person really was a shoo-in for the award. She had the most technical skills on the team. She was, I'd say, the hub of the tartan wheel. And she served as an inspiration to all the Holy Cross players and to many of our opponents and officials. Sometimes she tried to take on the burden of the whole team. And she did it often very successfully. She had over 5 goals and several assists for all her efforts, and she was selected to the WCAC first team for the second year in a row. The good news is that she's a junior, and we'll have her back next season. I'd like to congratulate Sydney Bruno. Showed steady determination and improvement throughout the season. Most importantly, she has a really great personality and disposition, and we loved her for it. And I say this because she always accepted Coach Benedetti and I when we would tease her. And she became sort of a joke, but the whipping girl on the team who always got blamed when the team forgot something or didn't listen to us. She always rallied during games, especially at the end of the season, and scored over 5 goals, including a hat trick in one game. Jenny Olcott, please come up to didn't start, she was a true leader, and Coach Benedetti and I could always count on her. She listened intently during every practice, helped to lead drills, was especially spirited, and was always, always one of the first players to help clean up and take out equipment. Carmen DePippo is an admirable person, and she is well deserving of the Tartan Award.
Coach Aaron Manning for our first.
Thanks, guys. those of you who don't know me, my name is Aaron Manning. This is my first year at Holy Cross, and I have the pleasure of coaching the freshman soccer team. I'm really happy that Mike and Lisa allowed me to be involved this year because I had a blast, and the team seemed to really enjoy our experience this season as well. I definitely grew as a coach, and the girls definitely grew as players and as people. We enjoyed a lot of success this season, finishing with a 5-2-1 record, scoring 23 goals and only letting up 10. We also enjoyed beating our rivals, Good Counsel, 2 out of 3 games, and thoroughly dominating the play in all 3 games. I really look forward to continuing to contribute to the Holy Cross soccer program in the next coming seasons. Also, a special shout-out to Annette Johnson, our manager of the season. Woo! She's a great help to me. She did everything I asked her and made my life a lot easier when I was at the practice field and ended up the game. So thank you, Annette. And now to our 3-season awards. The MVP award this season goes to someone who connected the team and brought life and joy to the group. She was our leading goal scorer this season, was one of our co-captains, and brought enthusiasm and energy to everything she did both on and off the field. I have no doubt that she will be very important to the soccer program here in the next coming years, so please give me a big hand for your MVP this season, Megan Monahan. The Most Improved Player Award this season was a no-brainer to me. If I compared her to the player she was at tryouts to the player she became after the season, they would be miles apart. She worked hard every single day, both at both practice and in the games, and has one of the best work ethic I've ever seen in a player. When one of our center backs suffered an injury, I had to call upon her to step up to the challenge and fill the gap, and she did so with confidence and with skill. After that game, she stamped her authority on that spot and played every single minute there for the rest of the season, and did so spectacularly. So would you please give a big hand for your Most Improved Player of this season, Natalie Young. The Tartan Award this season was a tough pick to me, but one student in the end stood out to me, and I had to go with her. She was a huge part of what our philosophy was all about this season, pressing the opposition to win the ball and possessing the ball to create chances to score. There were countless times this season where we needed a hero to save us, and she showed great determination, grit, and hustle to bail us out of improbable situations. Without her this season, we definitely would have had much harsher results and not as much success. Undoubtedly, she was an unsung hero for this season, which is why this gives me great pleasure to award this year's Tartan Award to Fiona Sheridan.
He's fine, just in a pretty bad car accident tonight. Car's totaled, but just couldn't make it. Fine, a little shook up, but he will not be able to make it tonight, so I'll cover for him. JV soccer. I'll just do this off the cuff then, I guess. Just really excited to reflect back on this season and just everything we accomplished with Coach Aaron, with the freshman team, and the JV as well. Can't tell you how many times I spoke with Coach Pedro after practice, on the weekends, just a random phone call. Quincy's down the street, just reminiscing over the week or the season, and just proud at how proud he was of the players sticking with it, players moving in, players moving out, this session, that session, and just very, very proud of that group. So can we give the JV soccer group a round of applause? I'll start with the Tartan Award, and I'm really glad. I think this is absolutely the correct award. This is a player who I actually had a really good conversation with at the end of last year. She was kind of doubting herself, not sure if she wanted to come out for the soccer program, and I gently nudged her in that direction, and I'm very, very glad that she decided to come on, an integral part of the JV machine this year, and I think she'll be a contributor to the soccer program moving forward. Can you give it up for your Tartan Award winner, Melina Skinner? Your JV Soccer Most Improved Award player goes to Lucy Young. JV Soccer MVP, Caroline Ionati. I'm the varsity soccer coach here. I'm going to do the varsity awards now. Okay. So just a quick recap of the season. In terms of results, our varsity soccer season was one of ups and downs. We notched a few quality wins, but got some really cool results and also had some tough losses along the way. I think we played our brand of soccer for the entire season, but didn't lift the trophy at the end. And I know that many coaches measure success in these terms, wins and losses, championship or bust. I think that's a good way to look at it, but I also think the ultimate measure of success is found in the experience of the group. And in that way, we couldn't have had a better year. These players and coaches created new and strengthened old relationships that will last through college and beyond, and now have memories that will last forever. And that, I think, is what it's all about. A shout out to the other sports for their seasons, as well as supporting us in ours. Can we give it up for the other sports? And to all Holy Cross students, for that matter, for coming out to our games, especially the quarterfinal at Good Counsel. We took a great deal of pride in having more than 100 girls at their field and experiencing the incredible spirit of the community. It lifted us, and we thank you for that. Thank yous also in order for our athletic athletics team, our athletic director, Ms. Lisa Schrader, our athletic trainer, Ms. Dina Rappaport, and our athletics utility woman, Ms. Deirdre Garahan. And as always, we appreciate the support from our administrators, especially our president, Ms. Katie Preble, who's here today, and our assistant principal of student affairs, Nelson Abreu. Can we give a round of applause for step along the way. And also, we'll go on to the awards. Quick shout out to a couple of our all-conference and all-staters. Honorable mention, all-WCAC, Amy Mortensen, Mary Muldoon, and Maddie Dent. Can we give it up for them? Second team, all-WCAC, Caroline Case. First team, all-WCAC, Sammy Ferguson. And also first team All-WCAC, as well as honorable mention All-State, our goalkeeper, Melanie McNamara. Okay, on to the awards. Most valuable player. Our MVP is a player about whom I cannot say much more than I did on her senior day introduction. She is the dream player for a coach with her leadership skills, the first to arrive and last to leave attitude, and not to mention her natural ability. She's just a good soccer player. But more importantly, she's a good person and is going to do some incredible things in college and beyond. As a coach, many players come and go over the years. A bunch will stick out in your mind when you reflect, but only a rare few, you can say, changed you and made you better. And this player is one of those. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for an outstanding young woman who not only made me a better coach, but also a better person. Caroline Case. Season. At this rate, if we see this type of improvement continue, the sky's the limit for this player. If she wants, she could be scary good. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for our most improved player, Sammy Slark. Being somewhat of a coach's award, the coaching staff and I spent a great deal of time discussing this one, and it was a really difficult decision. And that's a good thing, because we felt there were a number of players who deserved it for a number of different reasons. In the end, though, we agreed unanimously on this player who struggled with her role within the team at the beginning of the season, but regardless of lack of playing time or anything else, she put her hard hat on and went to work every single day. This player carried on and not only worked her way into the starting lineup, but also became an invaluable leader within the team and an absolute stud on the field. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for a player who embodies every philosophy of this program, including one we added this year, suffering, and who will get stuck into a challenge and win just about every head ball, our Tartan Award winner, Rebecca Enger.
Team for a really great season. It was a very tight team that was close and probably one of the more spirited ones that we've ever had. We've had more singing on the bus on this season than I've ever had in 7 years. I didn't know that we also sang in addition to playing tennis. That's good. It was a hard year to follow after how well we did last year, winning the whole league. We knew it was going to be a tough one. We knew it was going to be a rebuilding season because we lost quite a few seniors. But I could see everybody was worried at the beginning, and with all the new freshmen in, everybody was like panicking and sweating, and not just from playing tennis, just from worry. Even though I was also worried, I had to be the one that didn't show it. So I'm still worried just like they are, but I can't let them know that. And so I guess that's why I keep my Holy Cross hat on all the time, because it's black. And no one can see how gray my hair is getting. But tonight you can actually see how much more gray hair I have because of all the worries that these guys sent me. But despite that, they did very, very well. They weathered the storm. They handled the nerves. They did very, very well. And we ended up finishing fourth in the season. We came very close to becoming number third. So that means we have more steps to make next year when we try to do this thing all over again. One little experience I want to make sure everybody remembers is that I think next time you go to Ireland, remember to bring your passports, because when the bus took us to the Dulles Airport, nobody had any passports, so we couldn't go to Jamaica like we wanted to. So make sure you bring your passports with you when we go on the road trip, so in case we have to do a quick trip, we can, okay? So that was the longest trip ever. I think we got back to school like 9 o'clock. But you'd have to ask the team how that really happened. How did that end up at Dulles Airport? Probably with all the singing, I don't know. Okay, starting with the most improved player. This is a young lady who's been on the team for 3 years. She's a very quiet one. She doesn't really try to stand out or try to put herself up at the front. She's just steadily does her job and comes to practice and does as she's asked and listens to you, even though sometimes you're not sure if she's hearing you, but apparently she is, because she's getting better. And in the off season, she went away and she continued to work on a lot of the things that we talked about at practice. And in addition to that, just grew as a person. And she shows me that no matter how good we think we are, all of us have room for improvement. So when you think that you're there, sometimes you're really not. You can always learn from others, me included. Learning from everybody on the team. And she just impressed me with how she came back, and from having a building season last year to having a winning season this year, where she won 4 out of her 7 matches, and I think that was a good improvement for her, because I think she felt more confident and happy that, coach, I'm actually winning more matches than losing this year. So that was always a good thing to see when the person cuts themselves a little bit of slack to give themselves credit for the things that they've done. In a very humble way, not cocky. All right, so my most improved person for this year is Mary. So can Mary please come up? Destroyed everybody, and he was just an awesome tennis player. And it's always hard when you have a player of that caliber on the team with you, for you to feel that, you know, am I ever going to be able to get there? And when Shannon went to Penn State last year, this person had to step up into the role that where Shannon was. She did it, and more so. She also improved tremendously, and she was the only person on the team that never lost a singles match that she played this year. I think there was like three games. I think she lost six games for the whole season, meaning games in the sets. So, I mean, of the other eight matches, eight love, she was just destroying everybody. So there's only one person that we can give the most valuable player to this year, and that's Dory Mesmer. Challenging thing. I think she did it with grace and decency, and I think that I'm sorry she has to go, but I guess all of us graduate from high school eventually and must move on. Caroline, can you come up to the award?
With a 2.25 rating.
Serve receive. We struggled at the beginning, 1.17. Yeah, I know. We ended up at 1.88. So real nice improvement. Kills. Our first match, we had two. We had two kills in our first match. Two. We had 20 against St. John's in our last match. Received 2.0. She averaged over the season, averaged the entire season, 2.02. In addition, she served in over 90% of the time and had the most points on serve for the team. She anchored our defense in the wrong jersey. She was the one that was always confused about what uniform she should wear. She had the wrong color on all the time. She's our libero, our MVP this year, Sasha Carter. Yes! Serve. She had 7 kills. 7 kills. Very nice. Our most improved player, Elisa, no longer a tuna, with 2.44 ratings. Made a huge contribution there. In our first set against Good Count Books, she served 6 aces to get us off to a lot of points. We only statted 15 matches in that. She had 22 kills. As a backup setter, she had 20 assists. But you know what? That's not why she's getting the Tartan Award. She was a leader on and off the court. She was the one that always got our team started, our warm-up started. She got the work team together. One of my two very capable co-captains made my job so much easier. Our Tartan Award winner this year, Claire Coyle. Yes! Please, 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 please.
performance was pretty solid this year. We had a 18-3 record in the WCAC and 28-5 overall. Hard work, skill, and some luck, we were able to win our fifth consecutive WCAC championship. It's good to thank the coaches. It's also important to thank the parents for videotaping and hosting sleepovers and providing proper nutrition, getting girls to practice on time and picking them up on time. So thank you very much. I will particularly miss Tom Felsinelli's very colorful videos, colorful commentary. But I also really appreciate all the students, the faculty, and the staff who came to see us win the championship against Bishop O'Connell at St. John's. It was the difference, I think. So volleyball is a team sport, and I want to invite the varsity volleyball team up on the stage. If you would please come on. So we drew strength from across the team, our seniors, seasoned veterans, including our wonderful manager, Natalie Rollman. Two freshmen who made significant contributions, and several players, quite frankly, that were very nice surprises this year. There was one point in the season where I looked out and we had one junior, three sophomores, and two freshmen on the court. So their future is bright for the next couple of years. I also want to acknowledge the work of the athletic department, Ms. Schrader, Ms. Garham, and Ms. Rappaport for their tireless efforts. Okay, and a big shout out to Coach Singer, who did not only a great job with the junior varsity, but helped me with the varsity team, and Coaches Van Lowe and Rudder, who could not be here tonight. Starting off with the most improved. So this individual found herself on varsity and really didn't understand what that meant. So she started the season sitting on the bleachers during water breaks, checking her phone, not helping with the net setup. It was just incredible to me that this actually happened. I've never seen anything like this before. I was speechless. I didn't know what to do about it. But at some point, she woke up and realized how truly special it is to be given the gift of playing on varsity as a freshman. So she moved from error-prone, wide-eyed, to a solid contributor who could be trusted to perform at a high level, under stress, played in about a third of the team's games, found ways to help us through defense, hitting, serving. Past recipient of this award is Megan McTighe, the Gatorade Player of the Year for 2015, currently playing for University of Maryland College Park. I am hopeful that this new addition to the lacrosse volleyball program will achieve similar heights. This year's most improved player goes to Alejandra Serrano. Second award is the most valuable player. Let's see, who could this possibly be? This year's Most Valuable Player award goes to an individual who is a four-year varsity starter. Played on teams that compiled a combined 116-win-17-loss match record and won a WCAC championship every year she played. Finished her high school career total of 832 kills, This is the second highest number in school history, just behind Taylor Gallard, a four-time first-team all-conference player, currently a senior at the University of Central Florida. But that's actually a minor achievement compared to the next stat, which was she finished the all-time blocking leader in the history of the school. And what does that mean? Well, the person that Emily, sorry, I mentioned who the name was before. The person that this individual beat was Ramat Al-Hassan, who is currently an All-American in her junior at Florida. So she led the team in every attacking category, kills, kill percentage, hitting efficiency, carried the team on her shoulders throughout the playoffs. And this is a player who literally stands head and shoulders above her teammates. Our future UCLA Bruin, Emily Ryan. And the Tartan Award. So I select the recipient of the Tartan Award for their dedication, maturity, discipline, effort, and attitude. Award winners are usually not the best athlete or the best player, or the person who makes the greatest statistical contribution. So the Tartan Award goes to the player who pushes through every drill and every practice. Early practice, work hard, never take a playoff. Recipient of the Tartan Award is also a player who makes coaching a rewarding experience and from whom we as coaches learn the most. And I think several other coaches mentioned this in their speeches as well. It should be no surprise that this year's winner of the Tartan Award goes to the individual who won the school's most prestigious athletic award last year, Coach Sheehan Award for Excellence. Congratulations to Jessica Falsano.
I'd like the volleyball team to stay up here for a second, please. I have a special award for Coach Geiser and for Coach Singer. And it's the Academy of the Holy Cross Outstanding Coaching Award presented to Dave Geiser, for your leadership and dedication to the Academy of the Holy Cross Volleyball Program, WCAC Volleyball Championship 2016, five-peat. Delicious Uncle Ralph's cookies. I know, we wait all year for those Uncle Ralph's cookies. On the inside cover of your program is where you're going to meet with your team and coaches. So please, without further ado, have a great evening, a safe ride home, and enjoy the cookies. Thank you for coming.